Commissioner of District Two. To my right is County Administrator Mark Teal. I have Commissioner Mike Mulk here from the Third Commission District. I have Miguel Valentine, Director of Transportation. I have Gary Watson, Director of Multimodal Transportation, and to my left, I have Joby Milligan, who is serving as our committee secretary. That being said, let's go ahead and get into our adoption of our last meeting minutes. Has everybody had a chance to read the meeting minutes?
Yes, sir.
All at ease. Can I get a motion to accept those into record?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? None? It carries. All right, next up, second on the agenda item is Miguel, who wants to take Multimodal Services Branding? Gary Watson.
Okay, this morning I sent each of you an email regarding our negotiations with the collaborative firm. The email included the collaborative firm's scope of work, timeline, and proposed contract. Their price is $47,275. So I'm just asking members of the committee to look over and also members of the negotiating subcommittee to look over those items to see if there need to be any changes or corrections made to where we can move forward on that. The collaborative firm is wanting to start work around April the 1st. And Mark, a question that sort of came up last week, I'm not sure we decided on, is does the contract need to go before the full board again or?
According to Peacock, no.
Okay.
We took care of all that. We do need to get legal to check it if they hadn't already to make sure.
Yeah, they haven't seen it yet. Once we make all our corrections, I'll submit it to them to legal for review.
Okay.
So if everybody can do that for me quickly within the next couple of days, we'll be good to go.
Okay. So they've got it back, a decent scope of work, and what is their schedule? We will read it. Is it over 90 days, under 20 days, 6 months?
90 days.
90 days, 40,000. So, okay, I got the April 1st through June 30th.
Yes, sir.
Which coincides with the July 1st fiscal fiscal year of the state.
Correct.
Give or take. Okay. Okay. All right. So then, did you end of week? We need to get you comments back.
That would be great.
Okay. Commissioner Mulk here.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I haven't seen it, so it came out this morning, I guess.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I hadn't. I'm with him, so we'll respond accordingly. All right. Was it a long, is it long, or is it something we can get through? Is it
like, no, it's just short.
It's short.
Yes.
Okay, all right.
It's kind of 300 pages.
That's what you said, yeah, okay. So I will commit to having it that pretty timely.
It's like one or two pages, one day. Just not
okay. All right, so then let's move forward then on the third item. Transportation Center Expansion. We're going to have Dion. Who wants to take that one?
I'll take that one. And basically what I'm asking the committee to do is look at the exterior design so we can hopefully approve it and pass it on to the Board of Commissioners for their full approval. This is the existing part of the building here.
Can we do it? Can you reverse this so the camera can catch it? Which way is the camera looking?
This way.
That way. That's right.
That way.
You got it right.
This is
only right. That one is on.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
All right. Okay.
All right. So this is the existing part of the building.
Yep.
This is the expansion here. The only thing that's not correct is that we only have one bay instead of two. It's about a 6,200 square foot addition, and also we're renovating 500 square feet that's in our existing building that's adjacent to the new part. As you can see, we designed it to fit in with the existing transportation center. And we think it has a neat functional look, and we're excited to get this project started.
What gets taken away over there to right?
Parking spaces right in here.
I guess we're okay with parking?
Yeah, we've still got 600 spaces over there.
Yeah, there's a bay on that side, like a drive-through.
A drive-through.
Okay, that's where that is.
Which is where this portion is.
The drive-through goes away, and the expansion goes in there.
And so those are just windows, those are actually a bay area? What's the functionality?
That's a training bay where we'll be able to pull our small buses, our vans in, and drivers will be trained on how to check tire pressure, check oil, radiator fluids, basic, what we would call a basic day-to-day inspection of their vehicles.
And that's different. What you're saying is just truly training. This is not like what we're gonna be doing in our new Bleakley building in our fleet section, right? Which is no maintenance of the vehicles will be done here. This is strictly training and support for
that's correct.
Functions that we're delivering to the public. So
correct.
All MNO type stuff associated with this will be done back at the new building?
Yes, sir.
Well, the maintenance might be limited to refilling the windshield washer fluid or something like that.
Teaching the drivers how to do things like that. Very, very basic stuff.
I got you. But there's no fuel there. There's none of that stuff. Everything still will be taken care of back at the main.
Yes, everything will be taken care of at fleet.
And you did say one bay?
Yes, sir. Okay. One bay.
So, all right. So the expansion is just for that. So is there any office space needs? Was there a need to have additional personnel?
Yeah, there's some office space in there.
Yeah, we'll be... ride share multimodal itself will be gaining about 5 offices. As we've mentioned before, risk and safety is moving into this facility too. They'll have offices for their current 3 employees and 2 additional offices for potential future employees for them. We've also got a 40-seat training hall, lecture hall in there, plus a driving simulator that we'll use to train our bus drivers, our van drivers, and drivers of other vehicles in the county fleet.
I was going to ask, did you have a flight simulator since what you've answered it?
Yeah. Okay. It's going to be a very multifunctional building.
All right, so this expansion and things that we're talking about, like light simulators and simulator. Mm-hmm. Is that already paid? Do we have budget for that? Is that part of the?
Well, that's the next item on the agenda is furnishing and equipment, a
all
grant
right.
for
we
that.
Won't get ahead.
And so that's included in that.
Okay. All right. Again, so all right, we're talking about structural. Any other questions on this topic? So you're asking us what to do at this moment?
To basically approve the exterior design of the building.
Okay. Impervious surface, I don't know. I mean,
the impervious surface is the same.
It's the same?
Yeah, it's the same.
We didn't take away no green space, nothing like that?
No, we're putting it on existing asphalt.
So. Right. We, through Federal Transit, environmentally, we actually got a categorical exclusion.
Okay. So all that fuel and stuff, it ain't gonna run off nowhere out of there. I guess we already got buses coming along here. I'm just asking for the record. Commissioner Mulcair, you're?
Yeah, you're talking about adding some office space. I've been through this several times in the corporate world. You restructure, you change departments, and you add responsibilities, you deduct responsibilities, you furlough, you add staffing, et cetera. You walk around this building here and you see a lot of you see some empty, I don't say a lot, but you see some empty offices and empty cubicles. Are we focusing on hard wall office spaces, or are we utilizing some modular ideas in terms of the cubicle space where we enhance our flexibility?
This, in the addition, is all hard wall. Now, the existing transportation center, we have some cubicles. They work out okay, but everything in this new part is hard wall offices.
Well, everybody wants an office, they don't want a cubicle.
And one thing, yeah, one thing I forgot to mention that is also in this addition is a suite for drug testing, which again is a requirement from the Federal Transit Administration. And rather than having to send our drivers and other employees out to different locations to be drug tested, they'll come directly to our facility, which will be a big time saver.
That's good.
So are we consolidating that so that includes the sheriff and everybody else does drug testing? I mean, there won't be any independent drug testing based on because we believe we're sovereign conversation. I mean, is that the goal? I mean, it may not be true today, but is that the goal?
Well, we are building the drug testing suite because it's the testing is one of our requirements. Now, we'll make it available to other departments if they want to utilize it, but that'll be up to them.
All right, so. Commissioner Volker, is this something we should talk about, the full board of commissioners, about a policy dealing with drug testing? I mean, is there some leverage that can be done that, I don't know, we will see. I know the sheriff has to do a lot, the fire station, but they do a lot of drug testing, but nobody passes it. So, I mean, that means some kind of way we've got this expense going on. Do we have our handle on this?
Well, I don't know. It's not really contingent on what we decide here. It's independent of this.
Which is my point.
It's independent of this facility. It could be an agenda item for the public safety committee to, you know, how are we doing drug testing? What are the requirements? It may be that the sheriff has a facility already over there. I don't know. Or he may have a site where they send people. In that case, maybe they could send them here. But we really need to explore what's really happening right now.
Yeah, because you got other people too. You got HR, you got drug testing, you got accountability courts.
Yeah. If somebody has an accident, they got to be drug tested.
Mm-hmm. Well, let's. How about we just send this up as a discussion out the board commissioners and talk about it, and then figure out who's committed to give it to and take it out of this one. Can we do it that way?
As far as the drug testing?
Uh-huh. Separate.
Mm-hmm.
Can you, as county administrator, take this and bring the full board commissioners for us to discuss? It may fall into that, but I don't want to make a recommendation unilaterally over to another committee. Mr. Volker, are you okay with that?
It's fine. He's just county administrator.
Yeah, fine. That's fine. Well, I may have to have I might need to discuss this with all the other entities to see what their take is on it, to see what.
Yeah. You may be futile. You know.
Mm-hmm. And there's in my travels, there's been a concern about having the sheriff's department funnel all their folks to a known area because some of them don't want to be identified. And so, mm-hmm. you know, whether they want to send them
security,
for security.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I think sometimes we have to ask the question, well, why are we having these redundant functions all over the place? You know, and so we have to ask the question and get our minds around it, because I'm all about leverage. But find out, let us know. Okay. So to your point, you don't have to bring it forward, but yet until you find out some more background.
As far as your drug testing portion of this building, I mean, who does the drug testing?
We'll contract with a third party.
Yeah, so somebody else still does it.
Right.
That's not, we're not doing it in-house.
No.
All right, so we got 50.
That's just where we'll collect the bottles.
Exactly.
You got 10 to 15 contracts running around in this county. Is there some leverage? Is there an opportunity to go back and, I don't know if it's Travelers or whomever, I don't know these names of these companies, that can give us a rate that's reasonable based on our model size?
Package.
That's where I'm going.
Yeah. So if it's all third-party providers, which I'm assuming it is, then that would probably be a purchasing.
Yeah.
Purchasing
lab,
for them to go out and say, okay, is it cheaper for us to get one, mm-hmm. one drug testing lab, or
right.
is it cheaper to do them all separate?
Sure, and as I mentioned, convenience too, because we've got about three different providers now that we send people to, depending on the time and location of an accident. And so that this takes away all of that, they just come directly to this facility and get tested.
Can we save money like you did house? Yeah, can we look at that, your HR person, you guys, and let the board commissioners know? Taking it out of this committee, okay?
Okay, basically, all I'm asking the committee to do today is approve the exterior design of it.
Miguel?
It looks good to me.
Okay.
No problem.
All right.
Yep, looks good to me.
All right.
Now, do we need to take the actual facade like we did for the Blakely Building to the board commissioners for approval? Or do we take that to them when we already have the grant?
Correct.
We already have the grant, so we'll take it when we award, when we get authorization to go out for bid for construction?
We're about ready to do that. I would say within 2 weeks, we'll be ready to go out for bid. So I guess at that point, we would need to go before the board.
That facade is okay with everybody. We need approval.
Right, so I would do it, I would share, it's always better to just tell what you want to tell them. Share it with them ahead of time, and if there needs to be some suggested changes, you can respond prior to getting to that construction moment. It's just a suggestion. Can we vote here?
That's right, yeah.
Well, what I was planning on doing, and it's okay with the committee, the architect is going to have the letter-sized renderings of the exterior by the end of the week, and I was going to go ahead and put that on the agenda for the next commission work session. So they would have that for their approval before we go out for bids.
Yeah, we're thinking of copies of it ahead of time.
Right.
Yeah, I mean, there's nothing that prohibits presenting it to the board commissioners.
Yeah.
I mean, so you may have to just go around and talk to all of us and show us your board, but I mean, I don't.
Yeah.
Everything doesn't have to be formalized.
I mean, I can send it out to everybody in an email informally that way.
You could.
Some of you go ahead.
You're going to have to go touch them.
Yep.
Something like this, just go touch them. High touch, high touch. I mean, it's like us, sometimes we get caught up with the high technology. It's so much that we got to look at so quickly, and, you know, and it's just, if you want, you know, support. It's nothing to come in my office and say, hey, Ms. Ross, can you go look at this real quick? And that'll get me fashioned and thinking I'm going to get through 20 and 30 emails, guys. I'm just saying, if it's that important to you to make this deadline. What we want to avoid, though, is taking action where you've moved administratively and our commissioners are sitting there like, well, I didn't know anything about that. And we say, well, I sent it to you in an email. And yeah, you could legally say that was, you know, okay, but I did tell you. It's just my thoughts. It helps avoid. So let's go ahead, do first thing is first. Let's go ahead and so we're not going to take any action on that other than we're agreeing as a group that you're going to present it back to the full board of commissioners at your leisure. Is that correct?
That sounds good.
Mark?
Mm-hmm. And I can't see a lot of discussion. It's not like we're going to go to wood siding or, you know, metal siding or something. It's just
no hardy plank.
Yeah, yeah. It's just going to match the existing building. So.
Yeah, yeah, come on. Cool. Yeah. All right.
I could see a green roof. Go ahead.
No solar on that thing?
Come not
on.
Yet.
We missed that.
We'll find out about that tomorrow.
Yeah, yeah. All right, so let's move forward. Anything else on that one, Gary?
No, sir.
All right, so let's go to your next one.
Okay, so we have the grant in place for construction of this new facility.
Yeah.
What I'm requesting permission for now is to file the grant for the furnishings and equipment to go in this new addition. And actually, we discussed that in our January meeting. So this is just a remembrance of.
So the grant, which means that there's a match, which means the match has been accounted for in some source of funding, which I'm assuming is the Capital Transportation Fund, or is there somewhere else that the match will come from, if any?
Well, there's a $60,000 local match. This project is already in
the 2018 budget.
The 2018 budget.
In his budget or the Capital Transportation Fund?
In his budget.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Any thoughts?
No.
All right. So we, can I have a motion to make a recommendation to the full board of commissioners to move forward on this grant application?
Make a motion that we recommend that the full board approve forwarding the grant application for federal funds for furnishings and equipment.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any votes? Cheers. All right, very good. What is the furniture, I mean, this is just to his point, just furniture and fixtures, which is desks and carpeting, is it lighting?
Desk, credenzas, bookcases, and a big portion of that will be the simulator, which is about $130,000 piece of equipment.
How much total grant?
$300,000, $240,000 federal, $60,000 local.
Okay, so when you get that recommendation signed, put that on the agenda and get authorization to go out for authorization to apply for the grant.
Don't we already have it? Isn't that what the January 23rd recommendation was?
For yesterday?
I think we did that on
yesterday.
During our January meeting. Basically, what I was just doing today was trying to update or remind everybody that we were doing that, but I mean, it's a...
If we already did it, then we're good. But are you referring to the budget discussion where there's an allocation of funds for all these different things?
No, we had a specific discussion. I was wanting to apply for more buses, some more vans, the voucher program, and this particular grant. And we decided to hold off on some
on the buses.
On the buses.
Yeah, everything else.
The board.
Right.
Yeah, I'm starting to remember that.
Yeah, just make sure you got that documentation. If you do, then
it has to be included.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
All right.
So let's revisit the course of action we just said. Or if you're moving forward to apply for the grant with the furniture and fixtures for this.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. The source of funds, which is already in your budget, it's already been acknowledged by the full board of commissioners to go ahead and do this, is what I just heard.
To apply
yes. That's right. Mm-hmm. So this is just, and we're, as the commissioners are acknowledging administrative, we're agreeing, keep going.
Yeah. Right.
Technically we need to nullify that last motion.
Correct, and that's why I wanted to make sure we're not sending it forward.
I make a motion to nullify the last recommendation referring to grant application for federal funds for furnishings and equipment, item 4 of the agenda.
Second. Second. All right, that motion and a second, all in favor?
Aye.
Okay, so what we are agreeing is that we are acknowledging administratively for you to continue on.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So just to go with a formal statement for that, just to, as a committee, there's times where it's not really a formal recommendation, but it should be some type of administrative. We agree with you. Keep moving.
Okay. Right.
All right.
Sounds like administrative concurrence.
Mulgare?
Yeah.
Administrative concurrence?
Yeah, okay.
It sounds impressive.
You too.
Absolutely.
Okay, it sounds good. All right, let's keep going. Nothing else on that, Mark, you okay?
Mm-hmm.
Keep moving. All right, rule number 5. Actually.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, number 5.
Do you want to go back to 1 or?
Yeah, we missed number 1.
Yeah, because you.
Did we?
Mm-hmm. Mr. Blocks.
Oh,
my bad. 1. I'm about to know that in many minutes. Go ahead. Sorry.
Okay. So you have a copy of the latest edition of the 2018 SPLOSS resurfacing. Now, this is based on the feedback that I've received to date.
Mm-hmm.
And so this, if there are no other changes coming from any of the commissioners, then we will move forward and package this for bids. This will keep us within the $2.5 million allocation for resurfacing, SPLOSS resurfacing.
Yeah.
Of course, this is an estimate. When the bids come back, if they happen to be above this, and we'll have another discussion as to, do we want to remove some rows, or do we want to consider a higher allocation? But the expectation is that this will come in within the 2.5 allocation.
Okay, so just for the record, walk, it's not that big, so walk us through this.
Yes, and there's essentially a total of 8 rows, 2 per district, total of 12 and a half miles or so, and some of the commissioners have looked at the list. There's been amendments from the initial round of review, from the initial version. And so in District 1, there'd be Cave Springs Road from State Route 92 to Cedar Mountain Road, and South Sweetwater Road from US 78 to Lee Road. In District 2, there'd be Thornton Way from Skyview Drive to Thornton Road, Midway Road from US 78 to Pope Road. District 3, there'd be Big A Road from Kings Highway to State Route 166, and Kilroy Lane from Highway 5 to Big A Road. And District 4, North Helton Road from Post Road to Liberty Road, and South Flat Rock Road from Cedar Mountain to the city limits. So total of 8 roads, 12 and a half miles or so.
From Skyview Drive to Thornton Road. It's called Thornton Way.
Thornton Way, it's a short section.
Yes, I'm like, okay, I can't even.
Yeah, it's a small.
All right, I got that one. And then, of course, Midway is just, all right, I got that. That's almost 2.5 miles, okay. Commissioner Oker, what do you think about yours? You okay, just in general?
Yeah, Big A is serious need. It is exacerbated by the fact that the mile and a half north of Kings Highway has been paved, and you get off the new pavement, you get on the pockmarked delamination of the road, so it's quite noticeable that it needs to be paved. So yes, I'm satisfied.
Do we believe that, all right, so, and not that there's a real objective associated with using these SPLOST dollars, but how do we pick, just for the record, how do we pick this out of a list of all streets that are have some type of ranking, rating? Do we just go pick these as the next group? How do we get there?
Actually, to some extent, we have like a running list of roads that have been considered before and we didn't get to.
Okay.
Roads that have been requested to be looked at, and we've looked at, and we concur, so you could have a resident call up and say, my road needs paving, and we'll go out and make an assessment, and if we concur, then it goes on a list of pending potential roads. Yeah. So we take a batch of those roads, and then we try to come up with an estimate, and then split it between all the districts, and sometimes we may have to take a road that's 4 miles long and split it in 2 sections to be able to fit it within the budget. And so if we do that, the section that we didn't get to this time becomes a candidate for the next
one. Like Big A Road.
Like Big A Road.
Yeah.
And North Helton, there's another section of it that's not going to get done.
Now Big A, I think we got the whole thing on here though, right?
Yeah, in this particular case we do. But Big A Road was considered before, and it didn't get done.
No, it's not the whole length. It's Big A from Kings Highway to 166, which is half the road.
Yeah, that's right. It goes all the way. I got you.
Yeah.
Yep. You're right.
Well, you bring up a good point when I think about Riverside, which is 7.5 miles, and that took 7% of my budget 1 year.
Mm-hmm.
Right? It was wiped, right? Which is okay. I think the spirit of it is because that was the first year that it became a city road, became a county road, and so we wanted to show the spirit that, okay, we'll go ahead and we'll take that one, mm-hmm. take one for the team, but, yeah, I mean, that consumed everything, to my district, so, which, again, you have to spread around, but you get it, to your point. I don't know if you should have broke that up, maybe down to the American Red Cross, or maybe somewhere midway and keep going, but, I don't know, I mean, in that case, it's almost like you want to just get in there and get over it. Do the whole thing and be done with it, versus breaking it up, but I'm sure that each character in each district, a little bit different, so, it might have been easier chopping points.
Well, and you have a budget to contend with, if there's some roads that will skew the whole total. If you want to do all of North Helton, for example, that's an additional 2 miles of road, and it'll throw off, it'll put us well over 3 million.
And Splot concentrates more on thoroughfares and collectors versus the smaller residential streets.
Okay, so that's my point, so so back to objective, that we're looking at as a tool to go after the big stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's what we're
doing. So, Ripside should have been Splot, as opposed to some of our regular operations, which we'll come back later, so.
It was pre-Splot, but it was done with a contractor.
Okay, no, we're talking through about even Miguel's sake, and that we've had precedent here, and we've learned from it. Would I do it again? Probably not, but the fact that we did it, it's okay, it wasn't bad. Okay, Ms. Miroka, anything else?
No.
Do we go with this?
Absolutely.
All right, so is there a call to action, in that, we talked about this with the Board of Commissioners, I know this was sent back, we brought this up before as far as getting feedback. Is there a formal course of action is necessary?
No, not really. Once I hear from, the other commissioners on this version of the list, then we'll package it. I do not anticipate changes from this, but should there be, changes, then, we'll need to amend it again, but if not, we'll go out for bids based on this list.
And Commissioner Guyer, this is exactly what she wants. I haven't talked to Henry, so I think he's the only one left.
Yeah, reach out to him.
Right, well, then with that being said, because we have talked about this, and this is part of Splot, I mean, we've got to keep the process going. Administrative concurrence?
Yeah.
Yep.
And then we're ready to go out for bid once we talk to Henry.
Once we talk to him.
On this side of administrative concurrence. All right. Keep moving.
Okay, so.
Back down, go ahead.
Back to item 5, Whitestone Culvert. We had a discussion at the last meeting, really an update as to where we were. And I had indicated that we had reached out to a consulting firm, well, the original consulting firm that did the plans, for them to do the revisions, and it would be a contract coming back. But essentially, that was handled by way of a purchase order. So we now have the consultant working on the final design to bring the plans up to current standards and reflecting the conspan culvert versus the box culvert that was considered initially.
How big is this culvert? Big as a human? 3 inch?
It's big.
It's big.
Yeah. You could walk under it easily. You probably
like Chapel Hill golf course culvert right there.
Might be bigger.
Mm-hmm. It's bigger than that?
It might be. As far as height goes.
I think what was proposed initially was a triple or a double 10, but it was a triple 10 by 10.
10 by 10.
So it's 10 feet by 10 feet, so it's
30 by
10. Yes, it's huge.
That's big.
Really big.
Yeah.
You can drive a car there, small car.
Mm-hmm. Great. Okay.
In each section.
Or a boat.
Yeah, or a boat. Yeah, you probably a boat would be better, you're right.
Anyway, so that's where we are. So it's moving along. The consultant indicated that they thought it would take about 3 months to finalize the design.
Okay.
Next item, and that's it on
yep,
that item. Next item, we also talked at the last meeting about my review of the department needs and I passed. Gave you copies of the org chart and you took a look at that. I don't know where the board is in terms of considering additional positions. However, I would like, to the extent that there is the opportunity to consider additional positions, to to have some of those considered. One of the things that gives me a level of concern is the next item. One of the things that I discussed at the last meeting was particularly one of the positions for us to be able to track the funding on all of these projects and track the documents that we need. Because I was concerned about the possibility of an audit and not having all of the documentation that we need.
I think that was your first priority, as I recall.
That is correct.
And then the engineer inspector.
Yes, and it sounds like somebody was either listening to us or thinking along the same lines, because I've received notification that we are being audited on the Lee Road project. So we are doing everything we can to locate the records, pertinent records related to that project. It's been an ordeal, and it will continue to be, but it just underscores the need for this type of assistance in the department.
It's interesting that just yesterday in our finance committee meeting, I asked a little question about chair and finance director. Mark, you were there.
Mm-hmm.
Should we bring in a third-party audit to look at this project for us, our auditor? You know, we've got an auditor in there right now doing our current loan books, and is this sort of an expanded scope of services? Well, I guess that's answered. And again, it's so who is auditing us? Let me ask that question because I didn't hear.
The Georgia DOT. So they send personnel in to review our records for compliance. And so the records would be related to contracting documents, designs, property acquisitions, just, you know, anything that has been done with federal funding associated with it. So in the case of Lee Road, the original design probably has close to $750,000 in federal funds. The right-of-way acquisition is closer to $6 million in federal funds. So
let me ask you a quick question, and so back to your organizational chart, and I remember certain these are my files I've been going back over myself to, you know, since the beginning of time on transportation. There was something about a deputy person, a deputy manager or something of transit services. I saw a role somewhere in your chronology of what has happened since the past 3 years on. Are you asking for a grant manager for the sake of the conversation? I mean, you call it whatever you want to. This grant person, is this somebody who has a broader management role and that's their specific assignment? What are we being asked in your mind? Is it, because I'm hearing you're saying you need something. I'm hearing you say you need something. It sounds like they're related to a certain extent, or could they be?
We have a different set of rules and regulations than Miguel and DOT.
Why? Yeah, I mean,
it's transit as opposed to roads.
He deals with federal transit, and I deal with US DOT or federal highway. So they have different rules. Some of the rules are comparable. In fact, they may essentially ask for the same thing,
right?
Just using different verbiage, but one falls under the Federal Transit Agency,
yes,
and the other one under the Transportation Agency.
Okay, we don't distinguish in that. We're local, but I get it. But I also have to take into consideration local dollars, local, how we get, you know, it's sort of a either or, and could it be both? And we're just trying to, all right, so is your person already part of one of these grants where it's already included, or is that in addition to?
No, there's no grant funding available for this position, and I've asked for the position, but at this point, it has not been approved yet.
did we fund it? Did we box it? Or did we reserve, you know, sort of, we think we can put it here somewhere? No?
Well, it was one of my BIRs for 2018, and so, of course, the word we were getting is that at the end of March, that all of those will be revisited.
Okay. All right, well, you're done. And so then yours is separate?
Yes, it would be separate, and it's more an accounting function, because it's tracking the funding, tracking the billing that goes out.
These are full-time positions? I mean, is it that much volume that you gotta keep up with monthly?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you're sort of like, you're taking in invoices, you're reconciling, you're reporting, is that person. Is yours the same thing, just in a different hat?
Mine is more regulatory as opposed to finance.
And Miguel's is too, to a point, what he's asking for. They have to keep a file. Everything has to be in order. It's gotta have everything. Not just the financial piece.
Right.
But the whole file.
Okay.
Everything's gotta go, it's gotta be, you know, to Fed regulations.
And we don't think one person, Commissioner Mulcair, help me out on this. We don't think one person, because you got airline off. We're saying one person can't handle this at a local level, that we need two. Seeing that we're down a path here, it sounds like both are required, but at least I know yours is required. It sounds like yours is a really nice to have requirement. I mean, we have limited dollars. Let's just keep this honest. So just trying to get a feel, can we merge, can one person handle both until a point where it's like, I mean, they can put the structure in place, get all the files lined up, and as it comes in play, as the justification says, like, okay, this person can't handle both of these at the same time, then that gives you time to get another person in here, but trying to avoid which one would we support.
Well, I have an opinion, and I don't know to the issue, but can the job responsibilities be combined? I mean, I'm open to that. But it would occur to me that since we're facing a audit, this would be a good time to train somebody in an audit process and what to expect 2 years from now or 5 years from now if the issue comes up again, and how to monitor and catalog and sequence and record paperwork and stuff. To your point, mm-hmm. you're an internal transportation auditor.
And the audit, I don't know when the last time the county had a project audited, but they're becoming more and more frequent.
And this is a specific.
This is a specific
project.
A specific project. So yeah. they could decide later in the year to audit a different project, and so we'd be chasing after those files and records and trying to put everything together per the federal guidelines. It is quite a monumental task. You organize it and if you start from the beginning with the proper organization,
right,
then it's not as difficult a task. But part of the issue is that not all of that was done, or all the projects, and so we're having to chase after. And to give you an example of not just on the administrative side, but on the accounting side, we submitted an invoice on a different project a couple weeks ago, maybe 3 weeks ago, and the numbers were off by, I believe it was 27 cents between what GDOT records showed and what we showed.
Wow.
And it took us probably a week and a half to figure out where the discrepancy was. And some of it was due to rounding.
That's what I said.
Some of it was somebody transposed two numbers on an invoice. Mm-hmm. And you know, if you don't keep the records flowing properly, everything matching with making sure that you've got everything you need and it all adds up properly,
right,
down the road, trying to decipher what happened,
yep,
is just so much more difficult.
Okay. So, when will this audit be effective? Like, we received something formally in writing.
We have written requests, and they're looking for us to schedule it within the next.
And most of this deals with right of way acquisition. Is that correct?
The entire project.
Yeah.
So it could be contracting. Right, well, it would be design contracting.
Mm-hmm.
related to that, and right-of-way acquisition, utility coordination.
Yeah.
All of those elements, no construction, because we didn't get.
So some of that Brandy was doing.
Correct.
She's gone.
Correct.
Mahela was doing all the right-of-way.
Correct.
Mahela and/or Randy. So, right-of-way should be good.
The right-of-way.
She was doing the design.
What was the date you didn't finish your comment? What was your date?
Oh, sorry, I thought you said.
No, I just wanted to hear the date for record.
They're looking to schedule it with us within the next month or so. So, you know.
We've got enough time to sufficiently, and I'm gonna come back to the, this one. But is that enough time to find someone if it's so? You're already in play. We're already being audited, to your point. One of the remedies or cures associated with audits that have deficiencies, of course, is how do you improve going forward? To Commissioner Mulcahy's point, do we proactively get somebody here who's going to formally take over this function going forward, or are we thinking we're going to cross train? What were you thinking?
A, as opposed to B, in my opinion. And I don't know what the potential is. I feel stridently that we need to address this particular position. Is there, big question mark, is there somebody in our finance division presently that can transition to the transportation department and we can backfill finance? And that will at least give them a familiarity with the, you know, the organizational structure here and records and so forth. Just, I'm thinking out of the box, you know. Somebody that we can get from Jennifer's department and then just backfill Jennifer's department.
Well, in my mind, I realize this is a financial position and we try to stay away from what you're describing as a finance position, but in my mind, it's actually a project manager position, sort of. But what we don't want to do is we don't want finance split all over the place, just like we don't want Gary Jenkins with fleet split into, okay, fire department has their own.
Yeah, I understand.
Fleet,
yeah.
And so-and-so has their own fleet.
I'm just thinking of expedience, and that. I wasn't talking about not backfilling that position.
Yeah.
Back into finance, but maybe just, I defer to
well, Miguel. To your point, Mark, it is a comprehensive position.
Yeah.
It handles the financial side as well as the administrative side, as well as the regulatory side, in the sense that the financial components have to be in conformance with the regulations requirements.
So you're both not only a financial analyst, you're a business analyst and a project analyst, all rolled into one. So, and again, I've heard grants where you actually have to put money aside just to sort of support. That's what I was asking you, was your grant, did that grant actually have funding for it, where you can set aside 10% or 20% for the reporting part, but it sounds like it doesn't. So, okay. So let's hold this part there just for a hot second. I'm going to come back to Gary. Yours was actually, you at least put it within the BIRs. Was yours put inside the BIRs, Miguel? Or we just didn't, I mean?
That particular, well, that was BM.
So see, that's where I was just looking up. So what they had, so Miguel came on board in October. So what they had was a receptionist / secretary, and they had engineering inspector.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So the engineering inspector, what we had discussed at the budget retreat was that could be, it could be a engineering inspector / utility inspector, and then the portion for, we would use that for SPLOST. So the portion of their time that they spend on SPLOST inspections, then we could charge that SPLOST. As far as the position he's asking for, we discussed it at the budget retreat, but it wasn't on the list because it was before the year.
Yeah, that's the engineer.
Yeah.
Okay, I got you, I'm with you. So what are you suggesting? Okay. Yep. What are you suggesting?
Well, to Mark's point, as it relates to that position, I think it's a needed position. It reduces the county's exposure there are other positions that are actually funded from other sources that were part of that org chart request that Mark has alluded to.
Yep.
There's the contract or the project manager type and engineering field manager for inspections that we talked about.
Okay.
And that can be funded from fees from the right-of-way permits,
okay,
as well as SPLOST. So
fees and SPLOST can go into that as a sole source, but SPLOST may not always exist.
Correct.
Okay. Good to know. All right, Gary, let me ask a question for Gary. Do we think that the third-party operator, are they responsible for this compliance? No, that's conflict. We need to be monitoring them, right?
Exactly.
I'm thinking through this, but I know we already talked about that. I know about, transit manager. And it's just timing. You need this now, in the next 30 days or so, do you need to be scheduling?
I need to have somebody soon. Whether we can hire somebody in-house in 30 days, I don't know.
And this is where you bring in consultants. Do you bring in temporary people who are dedicated? You just need somebody to get you through this audit and be gone, like a flex organization. And I'm using temp loosely, but be seen, be gone, or you look for something that's permanent.
I'm looking for something that is permanent. Yeah. Because getting us through this one is only the beginning. We have many other projects that may be selected to be audited next month or the month after that or next year. We need to get those records organized and get everything lined up, be ready for them.
Yeah. And even if we're not pending audit, it needs to be done.
It needs to be done.
All right, so we had this vice president of the CPA of compliance when I first came on board. Remember, she was down the hall? What was her
name? Yeah.
Yeah. How do we ever use her? We really didn't, but is this what that was intended for?
Well, it was general building.
It was compliance.
Yeah, compliance. And it was,
she was the CPA?
Yeah, and it was focused on the at will of the commission, but it also included auditing of the commission expenses and
stuff
like that, but not
only. Not this.
Yeah.
No, she couldn't do
it. No, she was more of a fire spotter, I guess, or...
Okay. You know. Right. So, what can we do here? Again, by way of budget, Gary Dooley noted that it's the BIRS, and I understand that they are working through the process right now, and it was spoken of, and it's being looked at. So, that being said, I got that, meaning as a note, seeing how that, I guess the only thing is that yours is also needed immediately. Where we pull the money from? Do you have anything operationally in your budget, in kind or support? Or did somebody leave that we haven't backfilled yet, that perhaps that in the meantime, which has always been a practice here, says, well, I can convert this, I can do this versus that? I don't know.
Well, if you use money from a vacant position, then technically you're increasing the budget, because once you fill that position, theoretically, once you have all those employees for the whole year, then you're over budget. As far as money being available in that case, yes, there's money available in that case for this year.
But there is a BIR outstanding held in suspension for a receptionist, secretary, receptionist, or something in the suspended BIR 2018.
Yeah, there was.
Mm-hmm. There was one in there.
Okay, so
that's partial.
So both of them have BIRs that are pending for both their roles, respectively. In theory,
well,
that could be used as a
they're not pending.
Okay. What does that mean?
Meaning they were not on the list for the March revisit. So I'm checking on that.
Oh, that's news to me.
Well, it was news to me, too. Okay. And I looked it up and saw these.
Okay. Well, but here's, go back to maybe to Commissioner Mulcair's point. There's executive and then there's legislative. In our minds, we know that there was a list of things that didn't get done, right? And we just recognized that the entire list would be revisited in March. I'm sure that there was a calling administratively on what gets considered for revisiting. But again, the commissioners will weigh in, as we talked about that, we talked about this in the finance committee, that, and this is proving my point, commissioners may have, there has to be volatility in that calling for their input. We literally talked about this yesterday in finance, so Commissioner Mulcair, I think that there's, I mean, again, if there's 100 things and only 50 made it through to the next round, still only 50 things make it through, but there needs to be some type of smoothing out. Are you open with, for that type of dialogue?
Yeah, I understand what you're talking about.
Yeah, well, what I'm trying to say is that is all, the list has already been called. That wasn't on the list, but then the commissioners haven't had a say yet.
Right.
Just like the budget process.
Yeah, they have.
And, which is my
point. But also, we didn't have a say because it wasn't on the list. So why, my question to finance is going to be, why wasn't it on the list?
Okay, so that's a question for Jennifer and, and probably interaction with the chair.
Yeah, that's over there.
No, I'll talk to him.
All right, would you willing to go back in and have this conversation regarding these two functions?
Yeah.
Yuri?
Absolutely.
Miguel? So no action right now until Mark gets back to us. It doesn't have to be to our next meeting, but just let me and Commissioner Mulcair know.
Yeah.
And we can have dialogue.
I'm especially concerned, no animosity towards Gary, but my focus really is on this project manager slash finance.
Can I say something?
Please.
Yeah.
I'm not, is the transportation department the only department that has federal grants that you all have been receiving?
No.
Yeah, and judges, yeah.
Because overall, the county needs a grant manager. Federal government can go back 10 years or more with audits, with any money that's been coming into the county, not just for transportation.
Well, each department's responsible. Each department's responsible for maintaining their own grant.
The federal
department? Doesn't matter, whatever grant it is.
Okay.
A lot of them, the judicial side.
You're duly noted, good point. Again, back to, is it better to have a consolidated focus that is sort of like a matrix organization that supports it across? I think what you were trying to suggest, Commissioner Mulcair, with finance. All right. That's what I'm saying. These are, you guys are really part of the same organization, but yet we've got two, it's compliance, it's federal. I get that there may be some something around their discipline that's separate, but come on, the skill sets are transferable. You said project analysts, financial analysts, right? Those people who are familiar with those spaces. I mean, I'm thinking of other moderate-sized counties and smaller counties who may have federal grants. They don't have the balance sheet and cash flow that we have, perhaps. So how do they get around that? You got one person that sits there and figures it out. They become this you know, like a super project manager. They sit there and they go, whatever, super project analyst. And they get a little system in place. And they make it work. I'm trying to challenge this. Okay, do we need both? Can we have just one pay the premium for that super person as opposed to trying to keep them separate? Because what I haven't heard is that it's a requirement that they got to be separate functions, that this can only do FTA versus FTA. And I'm trying to avoid the either or.
I think if you put both functions on one person, that's a lot to ask of that one particular person. Would you agree with that?
Absolutely. And the issue with this exercise that we're going through now is that the risk is there for a repeat. We don't know how we're going to come out of this initial audit. What we, to the extent that there are deficiencies identified here, we need to be in position to remedy that in the future. We might be forgiven up to a point for having made a mistake at, one time, but if the next time something similar occurs, you need somebody that's tracking all of this stuff. And it's like I view the function of this individual as somebody wanted, having to go in for a deposition on some kind of construction project. They got to have every record that they need and be able to flip to it and say, it happened, here's the evidence that it happened on this date, and the invoice was for this amount, and it followed this criteria. We don't have that.
Yes, I mean, I've done cost controls and certified as a project manager, and so I'm sort of like, you know, I get this, right? So I'm still sitting here with the right mindset a person can get their minds around it. I get it. I think to your point, we want to get ahead of it. Now we're in the audit process. Let's get ahead, have somebody in place, take us forward. More conversation needs to be gone on this one. I don't think I'm in a position that I would. We should recommend it up yet, Mark, do you get back to us?
Okay.
On the money part, and just to Commissioner Mulcair's, I don't want it to be just out the blue. If there was some type of record that this, and we know it was, we just want to find where the record was. It was introduced to the Board of Commissioners through the budgeting process, what that was, and where it stands today on the, why it didn't make it through to the new list.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'll find that.
And you and I will have our conversation about we still can bring it forward.
And I think my concern would be not having this position, this project finance manager. kind of hybrid name now.
Mm-hmm. Right.
At least it keeps it straight in my head. Frankly, this audit could trigger curiosity about other projects, and it could expand.
Did they say why? We won't belabor this, but did they say
it's
why?
They're routine audits. They select from the region different agencies and different projects. They just pick one. And the problem is, if you have 15 of them, you don't know which one they're going to pick. So all of them need to be ready to be picked.
I understand. It was just sort of a coincidence. And again, this is for us. This is something we've been talking about for
a minute. And it is not. We were selected not for any specific reason. When I said maybe they were listening to us, our discussion last time, as we fictitious about that, but essentially they rotate amongst the agencies in the area. And, you know, I've been audited before. I've been audited two different projects on the same year.
Yeah.
Now, I had the files to be able to say, here it is. That was hard enough. In this particular case,
yeah,
it's going to be a different story.
But they have focused on a specific project.
Specific project.
Yeah, that's what worries me.
Right. And
something gave me interest in that.
Correct. That's, I'm not like, yeah, you're right. I'm not into the conspiracy theory, but I also know Douglas. So let's just say, okay, I'm good. Let's.
Maybe just because it was the biggest.
But I'm, I mean, on the hindsight, though, this fire drill that you've gone through to try to reconcile the capital transportation fund and then get into this one project that was sort of the bigger one that you couldn't resolve, that at least got you to at least that point where, again, you get it. At least you know at least what it must is, at least 95% of it where it is. So, all right. Is there anything else on this, Mark, that you need to know before moving forward for us?
No, sir.
Okay. Miguel, you okay? Commissioner Mulcair, no action until they get back to us, but duly noted.
Yeah, don't want to wait too long.
Yep. Gary, I mean, I get, you're part of this conversation, obviously, if you're thinking latter year versus current month, as far as timing concerned, I still think that there should be one in my mind for whatever reason, but I'm willing to work with the group, just those limited dollars, but there may be enough money there, Mark, let us know, because if it becomes a federal requirement, it's a requirement, and so once it becomes a mandate, in essence, then it's easier to have that conversation as opposed to not. So one is proactive and one is reactionary. Right?
Reactionary in a sense, just because of the timing, but proactive because we've got so many of these that we need to line up.
Get on up. Okay. All right. Next item, we got, what, two more?
Item seven, the only reason I put that on there is because I wanted to let you know that we are being audited on that project.
Yeah. Okay. Right.
And then the last item, that's...
All right, so anything else that needs to come before us? All hearts, minds are clear, you're good. LMIG, let's go back real quick, I just want to, just for clarity, not for the record, but we talked about the resurfacing for this lost.
Correct.
That's that. LMIG.
LMIG list was submitted to GDOT December of last year.
Yes.
And we've received a check for the funding formula amount.
Yes.
And that is now in our possession, so we're ready to start that. As soon as we complete last year's list, we will begin on a new list.
Yep. So the LMIG is being done by internal resources.
Correct.
Mr. Smoke, is that your understanding?
Mm-hmm.
And then the SPLOST is through our contractors.
Correct.
Do you got sufficient resources? I know you got the equipment, but you got sufficient resources to pull that off and be consistent?
I think so. And if the weather cooperates, I think we'll be fine.
Okay. Gary, anything else?
No, sir. I'm good.
Okay. We got one last item, and I'm going to call a recess to talk about. We have a set of citizens that wanted to speak with us. Commissioner Volker and I met with one group, and this group is out of District 1 earlier. No, take that back. That was last year we met, mm-hmm. but
late last year.
Commissioner met with a group of individuals. Commissioner Volker and I met with a subset of that group. This is another side of the argument, in essence, that wants to come speak with us, and so we're giving them a platform to speak today. Gary's just going to do a quick introduction for us, and we're just going to get in the floor to just be able to speak. We're trying to become a little bit more formalized, and Commissioner Mulcair, to your point, something we never had to do, we've never been in this place, but our committee structure has never been this, has never been formalized like this. And so we're going more to our hearing to give people a chance to speak. I don't see this as a, we have limited time, so we have some people who are already fixed as being able to speak. If we have sufficient time, if there's other people that want to speak, it's not a problem. And we go from there. There's no need. We are filming this, Mark?
Yes, sir.
In this room? It is being filmed, but we're not chronicling the minutes like, no, we've never chronicled public comments. Commissioner Volker, anything else?
No.
But we will not be fielding any questions other than for, I'll facilitate the acknowledgement of the comments and stuff, but let's, this is just the listen. Mark?
Mm-hmm.
You and I need to talk, so can we make sure we capture that type of conversation, but it's mm-hmm. not a debate. Mm-hmm. Gary?
Sounds good.
Okay. All right, so then we will recess this meeting until 5 o'clock. Thank you. Thank you, guys.
Sure.
All right. I thought it was 4 o'clock. Oh, God.
Did everybody sign?